Hello guys, my name is Willem and welcome to LRDX Cars. Today I'm at Garage Krone here in Lommel in Belgium to check out, like you can see behind me, the latest Corvette C8 Stingray. And in this latest model of Corvette, like you can see, this even is a convertible version. They went for the first time to put the engine in the mid-mounted, in the center place. So the weight distribution of the car is much better. And yeah, like you can see, the latest C8 Corvette has changed quite a lot. And yeah, in today's video, I want to talk you through some of the details, some of the changes, some of the features this latest C8 Corvette has. And yeah, before I go further, I want to say to all of you, please subscribe on the channel, because I have a lot of cool things planned in the coming weeks and coming months. I'll be going to Monterey Car Week, to the St. Moritz Car Week. We're going to Italy to some very special supercar manufacturers, so check them out. So yeah, please subscribe on the channel. And yeah, today I'm going to talk about the latest Corvette C8. Enjoy watching. And like I was saying, for the first time after 7 generations, a nice startup of the Corvette, they went for the first time to put the engine here in the center. Normally the Corvettes have the engine in the front, the front mounted engine, the V8, the big 6.2 liter V8, but now they went for the mid mounted setup. And yeah, like you can hear, it's a nice V8 grumble sound. I think the engine produces about 490 horsepower. Now we're gonna open up the roof system, that you have a quick look at how the roof system goes. 2 panels slide above the engine. Just a couple of minutes. Very nice. And like I was saying, they're using the 6.2 liter V8 engine, which will go from 0 to 60 or from 0 to 100 under 3 seconds, which is like really supercar fast. I think the top speed was about 193 miles an hour, which is a little bit more than 300 kilometers an hour. Yeah, like you can see, a full new look on this new Corvette. Normally you have the long bonnet, and now they have a shorter bonnet, still the trunk in the front. You have some luggage space in the front. And then, like you can see, a full new headlight design. Very cool, with a beautiful LED stripe in. And on the side also a nice LED stripe with even the little Corvette sign in. Then underneath we have the radiators, like you can see, very big air intakes with the cool mesh grill in front. And you can see this car also has a sort of front lip from standard, an extra lip to create some downforce on the front nose, with even some extra flicks on the side. Very good look, this car. Really like the blue color and the cool Corvette sign, Chevrolet Corvette. Very nice, very sharp lines, like you can see over the car. Here, those lines over the middle. Very cool look. And then stand here on the side. See the lip I was talking about more. And we come on the wheel design. Nice wheel design. Nice black with a silver pinstripe over. Now we're standing here. The air openings in the front. Of course also to cool the front wheel arches and the brakes, of course, in the front. I think these are just steel brakes. But yeah, it's also fine. Then we continue on the side of the car. Nice black side skirt that is a little bit open to manage the air on the side of the car. Then we also have on the side of the car an air intake, that when the air floats on the side of the car, it can come in right here and directly go to the engine bay. Now we can't see that much of the engine, but on the inside they also have some hardtop models, so maybe we can check those also out in a second. And then yeah, continue on the exterior. If you come on the rear of the car, okay, we can also see a full new rear of this latest C8 Stingraker vet. Now I quite like the design. You have sort of the Chevrolet lights, a bit coming from the Chevrolet, but you have a full new design and even some air openings on the rear also, again to cool the rear wheel arches and the rear wheel brakes, that the hot air can float out of those air meshes. And we see on the other side, you have two exhausts on each side. A beautiful V8 sound will come through. And we also have some, not that much of a diffuser, or I'm wrong, maybe if I get a bit down, you have a little bit of a diffuser. And here some extra meshes, some extra air outlets. And yeah, we have a cool spoiler design, which really suits the rear of the car. Thank you. If you have no spoiler, it wouldn't look that good, I think. And you have sort of the two targa humps for safety, of course, when you're driving a car with the roof off and you would crash it, that you're safe, that you won't break your neck or something. Have a really cool spoiler design, this one. Not that big or that crazy, but yeah, it really suits the rear of the car, I think. Quite like the new look. And we have here another cool, I think it's the Stingray hatch on the rear. Yeah, very cool car. And then, like I was saying, you can't see that much of the engine on this convertible version because you have the folding roof above, but normally you could see the V8. But we see that in the other cars on the inside. And then if you take a look on this full new interior of the latest Corvette. Nice, beautiful tan finish. Leather tan finish. With some black on the upper dashboard and full tan seats with even a nice carbon fiber inner. This is a nice Corvette. Safety belts. And if we come to the other side, we see the driver zone is sort of really separated from the passenger with a very big midden console where you can really put your arm on. You have some luggage space, even the big media display that you interact with the scrolling button underneath. And these are the park, reverse, neutral and drive. You have of course your flippers behind your beautiful Alcantara steering wheel with the 12 o'clock marker, also in 10. Nice 10 stitching also. And a full virtual cockpit with a beautiful carbon fiber finish on the side, very cool. Also here some carbon fiber inlays, very good looking interior. Then we have here a very big speaker system from where you can read Corvette Stingray on. Everything is finished quite well. Nice Alcantara here on the A-pillars, and I think also on the roof. Yeah, for the first time I think for an American looking interior, they really managed to do it quite well. Looks very good, I think. Nice startup. Nice. Rumbling V8. Yeah. I think we're gonna put the roof on again. Yes. Big folding panel comes up. With the two panels, slides above. Very handy, very fast. Just a couple of minutes. Very cool car, this one in the blue, the black roof and the tan interior. Really like it. Then if you're taking a look here on the inside here at Garage Krone in Lommel. You can see, like I was saying, they also have a hardtop version, a very bright one, and also another convertible. Yeah, I'm gonna also show some of the details of these cars here. This car is even for sale here at 134,000 euros. It's 1 year old, this car. I think it has just 10,000 kilometers or something. So yeah, if you're interested in your Corvette, then come to Garage Krone. I think they are one of the only importers in Belgium of the Corvette. Yeah, like you can see, they even have some second-hand models here. Or if you want to convert your own one, then you can come do it here. And they will help you with all their kindness. Yeah, I'm gonna also show this very bright one. Then we have this very bright stink acid green hardtop version here of the latest Corvette C8 Stingray on the inside, where, like I was saying, you can see the beautiful engine bay through. Nice V8 Corvette engine, 6.2 liters, 490 horsepower, think about 375 pounds feet of torque, top speed of 193 miles an hour. 0 to 60 in just 2.9 seconds. And yeah, I really like the new look, I think, of the latest Corvette. The old shape was getting a bit outdated, and yeah, now they're gone for a full new, fresh look on this Corvette C8. Cool new headlights, very sharp nose that comes in a point in the front. Really Ferrari looking sports car, this one. All the cool meshes here, the fins in. Cool hexagonal shape also, I think, in the grill. A very cool car. Also the nice black finishes, like the side skirts, the wheels, the mirrors, the side of the air intake. And this is then the hardtop model. No folding in of this. You have even a camera above and a camera here. I think the car also has a 360 degree camera view, which is also quite handy on, yeah, a sports car of more than 100,000 euros. It's always nice to not scratch it. Yeah, very cool look. Also the black sort of diffuser bumper, black finishes. Yeah, it really contrasts very good, I think, on the acid green, the very bright color. And with all the black finishes, like the Corvette logo and things like that. I very much like this car. It'd be very cool. Like I was saying, it's for sale here. 17,000 kilometers, 134. It has some cruise control, Bluetooth navigation, all the things you need. And on the plaque it also says that this car has the Akrapovic exhaust system. So yeah, maybe have a closer look on those exhausts. I think that car on the I side also had it. Yeah, the car will probably make a very good noise also, this one. I think it's the same noise as we heard on the outside of that blue one. Yeah, I really like the V8 grumble, with nice V8 sound. Can't compare it with engines from here in Europe. You really know that this is an American produced car with a nice American V8 sound. Then we have another silver car here on the inside, another convertible of the C8 Stingray. Now you can see Garage Kronen is really one of the only ones to sell Chevrolet and Corvette here. They also offer the Camaro here. Maybe in the future we can also come and take a look at that car. But they don't have one in the showroom. They only have one in the workshop for now. Yeah, very cool. Full lip. This one is driven quite well. A lot of flies on. Yeah, but prefer of course the acid green look. But yeah, if you're a more older guy, or you like the more classy look, and this is also a very good looking car. And the special thing on this car is the beautiful interior. You have more the white and the black leather interior with the white stitch. Very good look. Quite like it. Classy look. Then the convertible roof folds in, like we just saw on the outside. Yeah, this one has a bit of a lower spoiler if you compare it with the other one. think that is maybe an option, the spoiler. And this is more the regular, or this is the option and that one is the regular one. Yeah, we can see this car has some other exhausts on it. I think this ones are the Akrapovic and the other ones are more the standard one, because you have here Akrapovic on the side. And like we just saw, the other ones, they had a bit of a different shape, and also on the inside it was finished a bit different. So this car will probably have an even crazier sound, an even better sound. Very cool. Then I was talking a bit with the salesperson here at Garage Kronen. He said he already had sold about 20 cars that still are coming. So yeah, they are really good selling here in Belgium even. I wouldn't think that. And there are some cool features that I was telling to you about the kit that you have here. It's a full carbon fiber kit. They are now painted in black, but yeah, it's real carbon fiber, the side skirt and the front lip. Even the spoiler under here, because yeah, if you compare it with the other car, that car doesn't have the kit. And yeah, it's an extra option of about 10,000 euros, so yeah, not that cheap option. But yeah, like you can see, it really makes a much more aggressive look. The extra flicks and the side skirt and the bit bigger wing. And the salesperson also said that even that wing is an extra option. It are of course all factory options, but yeah, they really need to put it here in the garage on. It's not that they put it in the factory on. So normally the latest Corvette C8 Stingray does not have a rear spoiler, which is, yeah, I think a bit weird. But yeah, I think a lot of customers will of course go for this or the other one. I think we will see this one the most, because yeah, it's not that cheap option, the kit, because yeah, it's of course also a lot of carbon fiber. And I said this is sort of acid green color, but it's more a yellow color, very bright yellow color. It's also an extra option. And also something cool, that's why the engine bonnet is open always on every Corvette model, even if it's not a convertible one. You can always put the roof off. It's one big panel. It will not be automatic, but yeah, you can do it with your hands. Maybe I'm gonna even show it to you. Take a look on the interior. You can click it here. You can click it loose. Click it here loose. And then you can put the panel, the one big panel, here in the rear of the car. In the little trunk it has. It's very cool. I didn't even know the car has a trunk. And you can, it is perfectly fitting. That's why the latches are there, I think, that you can put the roof panel in and it won't vibrate or anything like that. It will be very good in place. Like you can see, it's really made the place for the roof to put. And then another cool thing, the salesperson was saying, another option this car has, because this is a very good optioned car, is the magnetic ride control. It's this, the magnetic ride control, that you can even choose the damping and the suspension setup of the car. That if you're taking it on track, you can put it in a track mode and the suspension will be a bit harder. Or if you just put it in normal mode or in sport mode, it will be a bit softer. Yeah, very cool look to the engine bay. A lot going on here, very big 6.2 liter V8. Nice carbon fiber A-pillars and things like that. Because this car has, of course, a lot of options. Also has a lot of carbon fiber options, so you will also see on the inside. And yeah, very cool look. The owner also said that this one and the blue one we saw on the outside were the first European cars. And this is even an imported car. Because yeah, this was the first car to come here to Lommel. This car was really the car that sold all those cars. It attracted all the customers. And the owner said that of course this car will be a lot louder, because it does not have the OPF filters And even with the Akrapovic exhaust system, like I was saying to you a minute ago, is crazy loud, he said. he said it's another sound than those cars. And I even thought the sound of the car on the outside was quite good. Then the salesperson also said that you have two sorts of trim level on the inside. I think he said the LT2 and the LT3. And that car with the white and black leather is more of the standard interior look, with the more standard sport seats in. And then this car has more upgraded interior with the beautiful Alcantara and leather, beautiful yellow stitching, nice Bose sound system, looks very good, nice carbon fiber inlays. And you have here the Stingray badge on the dorsal. And yeah, like I was saying, these are all carbon fiber parts. I think they should have left it a bit open, the carbon fiber. Then also this car has more upgraded bucket seats, not more the standard comfortable sport seats. You can see you have much more support on the side of the car. And yeah, the nice perforated Alcantara inner. Beautiful carbon fiber on the inside of the seats. Nice matching yellow seat belts. And if you take a look here, we see the beautiful engine bay, always nice to look at. Also nice Alcantara, very beautifully finished, the headliner, even the sun mirrors, very beautiful finish. Yeah, quite cool, this look. Then I'm gonna take a quick step inside. Then, if I took a place here on the inside, maybe close the door for a minute. It's a very, very good look, this car. Beautiful carbon fiber. Very clear view. You have the virtual cockpit. That you have all the information, the nice pedals behind the steering wheel. The nice 12 o'clock racing mark. The shape of the steering wheel is also quite more squared. Shape, quite cool with the flat underside. It's very nice. Some buttons to change some information. Very special design of the air conditioning roosters or vents. Very cool. Then, like I said, on the car on the outside, you have the very big center console where it separates a bit the driver and the passenger. We have this button underneath where you can interact that screen with. I think where you have all the navigation and the media and things like that. I think this is the sound button and the home button. You have some cup holders here underneath. Very handy always. It's very beautiful, the Alcantara finishes here. Then underneath here, we have some charging ports for your phone. And very cool finished. You have all the buttons here, subtly finished in the side of the car. Seat heating and cooling. Air conditioning. The seat heating cooling of the other person. Yeah, all the air conditioning buttons just subtly put on the side. Not 20 buttons on one place, but yeah, very cool designed. Then you have also the beautiful air conditioning vents. Very special look, then another cool sound system. Yeah, really cool car, this one. I really like it. I really like the Corvette Stingray C8. I think for the price, I think it starts at about 130,000 euros. I think you don't even have a 911 for that kind of money. And this car has 490 horsepower, will be faster than under 3 seconds from 0 to 100, we'll be driving more than 300 kilometers an hour. So yeah, for a car, that's price point. And yeah, you really have, if you spec it like this yellow car, if you spec it quite nice, you really have a supercar, I would say a sports car, but this even is a real supercar with that kind of performance, and yeah, you have the exotic look to it. It's not your average Porsche 911 look or your just BMW or Mercedes or anything Audi look, that you just take a sport pack and it almost looks like the same car, but you pay twice as much. And yeah, I think Corvette did it very good with this car, full fresh new look to it, with a mid-mounted engine, that you have better center point of gravity. And yeah, in this video sadly won't drive this car. I hope in the future, if you guys leave a lot of likes and watch this video a lot. Yeah, I read about some other journalists and other YouTubers that surprisingly the car also drives very well, of course because of the mid-mounted engine. Yeah, the car has a lot of power to it, and yeah, I really like this car. Really like all the finishes. The inside is finished very well, I think, for the first time for an American car. Yeah, normally everything is a lot of plastic and looks like just any regular Chevrolet on the inside, but now they really done it very well, I think. But yeah, I quite like it. And yeah, if you are interested in a Chevrolet, even if it's not the Corvette Stingray, even if you want the Camaro or anything, then yeah, please come to Garage Krone here in Lommel, because yeah, they are one of the only guys that are selling American cars here. Then something I just saw was, this is the mode button. This is not the button to interact the steering wheel. It will be from your race mode and sport mode and things like that. And like I was saying, the suspension setup will also be, the magnetic ride suspension will also be depending on the modes. Then yeah, you have here the manual. If you want to drive it manual, the button that you can use the pedals, the drive, neutral, reverse and park. Yeah, not too much going on. Really like it. This car, very cool finish. I'm gonna get out for now. Very cool is you not have a door handle. Just push this button and the car will open up. Very cool. Also the settings of your seats automatically. Little space to put your phone or anything. Yeah, very cool. Really like this wild color. That was a quite loud startup. The guys here at the garage always try to fool me, because you can start the car on the key. That is the American car. With that Kravovich exhaust system. Very loud car. I think he now opened up even the... Yeah, that's something else. Now, I also opened up the front bonnet, that you can also have a look on the little front. You can also put some luggage in the front, just a bag or anything, or even a small trolley. Yeah, but it's cool that you have the front luggage compartment. And even the rear, that yeah, if you are not putting the roof in, it's quite a big rear luggage space, or here trunk. Normally in a supercar of 500 horsepower, you don't have that much of storage space. And yeah, it's quite cool to have a lot of storage space in your car if you want to take it on a road trip or anything like that. Yeah, we heard the American car, and yeah, like in here, this car was way louder. And when you open up the Krapovich sound system, it's another sound, this car. It's really immense. Leave a like on the video if you liked it. Big thanks to Garage Krone, of course. And yeah, please subscribe on the channel, because yeah, we'll be doing a lot of car reviews and a lot of car events in the coming months. And yeah, it's now my job. So yeah, please follow the journey and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.